What's up, guys? This is Coach Donny with ElevateYourself.org. I recently attended the USA Volleyball High Performance Coaching Clinic from February 9th to 11th of 2017, and I made this vlog about my experience at the coaching clinic. Also, if you're new to my YouTube channel, don't forget to subscribe to my channel to watch volleyball tutorial and highlight videos, as well as jump training videos. If you would like to sign up for next year's USA Volleyball High Performance Coaching Clinic, which I highly recommend that you do, you can sign up on the USA Volleyball website, which can be found in the description box below. I hope you guys enjoy my vlog. About to board the plane for the USA Volleyball HP Coaching Clinic. We got Coach T, we got Coach Long. We're about to meet the legendary Karch Karai and learn some true volleyball skills. Not the ancient volleyball techniques, but the real, real ancient ones. As soon as I stepped off the plane, I ran into Matt Furbringer. Welcome to the Olympic Training Center, where gold medals are built. USA. That's where we're at, Colorado Springs. This is my key and this is my participation tag. It's starting to get real. These are our dorms that we're going to be staying in, room 85.
Yeah, 200, 300 sometime.
This is where we'll be playing nine man. Room 213. Not bad. This is what our dorm looks like. This is actually like a luxury dorm if we're in college. Yep. This was our schedule for the first day, and we actually checked in at around 3:30. We're about to go get some dinner and then head on to the opening presentation. We are on the hunt for some food.
Just want to tell you, I watched you on the video.
Oh, hey. What's your name?
John.
John, nice to meet you. Yeah, sport nutrition, timing. Select good food, got a salad bar, and there's Matt Furbringer. This is what the dining commons looks like. We got pasta with marinara sauce. Chicken with some type of gravy, pork tenderloin, I think these are candied yams or carrots, pasta with white sauce, chicken quesadillas with cheese, guacamole, jalapeno salsa, and guava passion fruit juice. We just finished eating dinner. Well, it was actually pretty not bad. What'd you guys think of the dinner?
That was good.
Pretty good.
It was good. Healthy.
It's healthy, of course, because I gotta feed the Olympic athletes here. I'll say the chicken quesadilla is pretty good. Now we're on our way to walk to the visitor center, which is where the seminar will take place. And we will get to meet the legendary Karch Karai.
Oh, yeah.
So, visitor center is all the way down. You see these Team USA signs everywhere. And it's cool, I actually saw some people from Canada and like other countries that I think are attending this clinic as well. They have an oxygen tank over there in case someone faints when they meet Karch Karai. Wow, this is their, looks like a weight training area.
don't know if we can go in, probably not. We're about to enter the visitor center. Hello.
Welcome, come on in.
Thank you. No problem. Wow.
Really? The next day? They'd already started.
The evening was started with what they call Ignite Talks, where some of the main speakers talked about what they will be covering over the course of the clinic. And the theme of the clinic was transitions. Karch talked about his transition from being a player to a coach for the national team. Kathy talked about some of the transitions that she went through as a young coach and the challenges that came with that. Here's a humorous slide that Jared Elliott, who is the head coach of the Texas Longhorns, put up when he talked about his losses in the NCAA finals with his team and how he re-evaluated the way he was coaching and essentially rediscovered his passion to coach. After the presentation, we had a chance to socialize with other participants from the clinic, as well as the speakers. I met with Kathy DeBoer, who is the executive director of the American Volleyball Coaches Association, Doug Beal, who was the former CEO of USA Volleyball, the legendary Karch Karai, who is the current USA Women's National Team head coach, and a list of many other accomplishments which are too long to list. And Jared Elliott, who is the head coach of the University of Texas women's volleyball team.
We're here at the Rabbit Hole because it's, what is it, 9:30?
11.
11 right now? Holy, never mind. It's 11, the session's just ended at 8:30. And the dining hall is closed, and we're hungry. We got our food. We just want to fill ourselves up. We got a beef tenderloin burger with some sweet potato fries. Burger. We got
mac and cheese.
Mac and cheese with chicken and a little dance and cauliflower. And we got some Brussels sprouts. So we should be able to sleep well tonight because we got to wake up at 6:30, breakfast at 7, and then it starts at 7:45. We just ate at a restaurant called the Rabbit Hole, and you can see why. Well, the light's off, but it says the Rabbit Hole. And the burgers were pretty dang good. Now we're in a food coma and ready to go to sleep for tomorrow.
Here's our schedule for the second day, and as you can see, it's pretty packed from morning till evening.
About to get some breakfast, 7 a.m. right now, and look at that beautiful Colorado mountain. Let's see if I can zoom in. Looks exactly like a Coors advertisement or their package. Couldn't really sleep well last night. I think the other guys didn't sleep well either. Either we're too excited or we couldn't get used to the sleeping environment. But we're at breakfast.
We got our potatoes, complex carbs, meat, protein, a little bit of fiber here, and some milk, and I'm waiting on my omelet.
So Coach T is the master traveler. He ordered an omelet and is now making like a bagel sandwich.
Breakfast of champions.
He takes traveling to a new level, new ideas. He even put
some pepper on his cantaloupe. So we call it level 2 material. He brought like 3 pairs of slippers. His soap is pre-wrapped. And Lam loves to stay up for 28 hours at a time.
Yes, I do.
He worked a night shift and then traveled all the way to Colorado. And then we forced him to go out to eat with us.
Jared Elliott is the first speaker, and he talks about middle blocker transition.
Okay, the first step is a step in with our right foot. The second one is a throw. Okay, and they're just in the same position. Left foot is forward, they're balanced, and then the third step is here. And they're coming up. And what you see a lot is when you start training this, your good players will come here, they'll step here, one, and they'll wait for the step or speed of the moment to be able to get up. Okay? So we want them to be in a very efficient motion. And so for training, we just basically have them land, step, throw, make an approach, okay? Step, throw, make an approach, and they kind of just go down a lot, just learning this concept to be very efficient and keep their back very still, okay? And be in a position. So let's see if we can do this. Good. Step off. Just this basic concept. Okay, as we go with this. Basic footwork, how to keep the feet on anything so they're efficient people. Now keep off good. Pretty good. It's nice. There's not a whole lot of wasted motion. Again, ladies, you're coming towards me more.
In session 2, Keegan Cook, who is the University of Washington women's volleyball head coach, talks about creating and converting from common and uncommon situations when it comes to transition offense.
Oh, nice turn. Let's get a bonus there since it was an ace. Good swing. We got a transition ball now. Find the dig, Elise. Find the dig. That was good. Good swing. Elise, come on back down. My favorite thing about that transition is you did the third thing, which is really important. So we have to move well, and we have to see well, and we have to communicate well. So what did you yell as you were coming off the net here? You're yelling forward. You saw the dig. You were ready to go. You're yelling four, four, four. Is that what you guys run out here? Do you run anything else? Or is it just a four? Just a four.
Beth Lanier, who is the University of Utah women's volleyball head coach, talked about how to side out in serve-receive against the international level serve.
Right. So what are the issues here? How do we get good at medium pass? But obviously, we don't have a block in front of us right now, so things that we would be focusing on, number one, can we keep the speed of the set going? Obviously, it's not the same maybe with younger teams, but can we still run our offense fast from the 10-foot line? So we work on running fast from the 10 to 12-foot line a lot. So you're trying to attack the block, try to get a kill, try to touch that block. Okay, good. Give her a hand. She got it. Attack the block. Good job.
We're here eating lunch. This is what's on the menu.
Got steamed broccoli, air crisp chips, some pita bread, guacamole, clam chowder, tuna sandwich on an English muffin. This looks like a tortellini Spanish lasagna, salmon. And the best surprise is we have some pho. We've been craving some Asian food, so we'll see how it tastes.
In session 4, Jesse Tupac and Nikki Holmes talk about adapting data volley during a match and how to use statistics to plan for your opponent and how to make game decisions based on that data. Jimmy Stitz is the sports physiologist for USA Volleyball. He talked about the type of training that is necessary to prepare volleyball athletes at all levels, and he shared what they do for the USA indoor and beach athletes. Here he talks about the force velocity curve, which is important for understanding how to plan for in-season and off-season training to maximize your ability when playing volleyball. Lastly, he talks about the type of conditioning he recommends for different levels of athletes. And now the moment that we've all been waiting for, Karch Karai's presentation. If you would like to see the entire 1 hour presentation by Karch, please click on the video link in the description box below. It's not very often that you get to listen to a living legend, so I highly recommend watching the full video.
What are we doing in here and not going straight to the gym and playing some volleyball after that? My gosh. I'm ready to go. It's just all of these beginnings and all of these things that I've been through have been learning adventures. We're trying to build a culture of not being afraid of making mistakes, because we know that we're impeding our learning process if we're not trying new stuff, if we're not operating at the edge of our abilities, then we're going to learn at a slower rate. And if we are screwing up, and if we are trying things in the gym that are ugly and chaotic and random, and it looks awful at first, but it has to.
All right, about to work out in the USA Olympic gym. This is as close as we're gonna get to Olympic level gold medal training.
It was amazing and surreal to work out at the Olympic Training Center gym because I used the same equipment that other Olympians have used. So I felt like an Olympian for about 30 minutes.
Just had a pretty short, fun workout at the training weightlifting area at the Olympic Training Center. So that was fun. Now eating dinner.
We got the spaghetti, egg, frittata, spinach and potato sog with steak, steamed veggies, catfish wrap, it's probably some type of veggie, and it looks like a minestrone soup. And I'm still a kid because I love chocolate milk, so that's what I got for the drink.
We just finished eating dinner and we're about to watch our special event session at 7 p.m. and two of the really good coaches from the collegiate circuit, Keegan from University of Washington and Beth from University of Colorado, are going to get mic'd up, and we're going to hear their feedback to the players. So they're actually going to coach two youth teams live so we can hear how they manage the players, what feedback they give. So that's going to be the entire session, which is cool because we get some of that live feedback and read into their body language and when they call timeouts and stuff like that. So right now they're just warming up. So that's University of Colorado, Utah coach, and that's the University of Washington coach. And then we have an amazing photo of Clay Stanley crushing probably a D-ball against Russia. This truly is an amazing place.
First, let's go. How much better is that?
and here I'm channeling the spirit of Clay Stanley in hopes that I can hit as hard as him someday. Here's our schedule for the last day. As you can see, it's another packed schedule with non-stop volleyball action.
Having breakfast on our last day of the coaching clinic. As you can see, my voice is gone from all the talking. Here's a funny story. So Coach T over there and me, we try to wake up an hour early to work out in the strength and conditioning building. We're all pumped up and we wake up at 6 a.m. then we go to the gym. And of course it's closed, and we find out that on weekends, on Saturday, it closes, or it doesn't open until 8:30 instead of the usual 6 o'clock. And T, what lesson did we learn today about the bird?
Early bird never gets the worm if the worm's not ready to get.
Yeah, sometimes the worm has to wake up just as early so the bird can eat it. But so, wise words from Coach T. We needed more worms today, we didn't get any. So woke up early, and we just ended up going back and laying down in our dorm until breakfast was ready at 7. Now the man who was actually inadvertently wise was Lam. He was too tired to work out with us, so he actually ended up getting sleep, so it actually worked out better. So and we got this amazingly delicious guava passion fruit juice. I'm seriously gonna get diabetes because I think I drank like 20 cups of this.
Everywhere we walked, there were inspirational quotes and images that were very uplifting and motivated you to become better at whatever you were doing. I feel inspired even when I go to the bathroom here, like I have to pee for the longest time possible or take the biggest dump ever. During our first session of the day, Beth talked about blocking against in-system and out-of-system offenses. In the next session, Keegan Cook talks about how to create your team's identity. Aaron Brock is the Director of Sports Medicine and Performance for the U.S. National Teams and the Athletic Trainer to the U.S. Men's National Team. He specifically talked about the concept of recovery, how to gauge the intensity of your workouts, and how to minimize injury while maximizing your performance. The last session of the morning was given by Shelton Collier and Jonah Carson, and they talked about the importance of having a coaching mentor, specifically an experienced coach who can give you an outside perspective on how to improve your coaching ability.
Lunchtime is pork loin, Mexican potatoes, string beans, Mexican rice, black beans, and I made my own vegetable soup with a slice of cheese inside and some sandwich meat and green onions.
The session after lunch was given by Matt Furbringer, who talked about how to maximize transition opportunities. Then Karch followed up by teaching how to see the game in transition.
About to check out the Team USA clothing store. Got some cool hats. Doesn't look like any sport-specific gear, just Team USA stuff. Got some water bottles over here. Let's take a look at these watches. That's the store.
Kathy talked about the evolution of coaching techniques from the 40s and 50s to modern day coaching styles. and how it's important to identify your coaching personality traits so you know which areas to work on and which areas to emphasize. The last session was given by Bill Hammeter, who is the USA Women's National Sitting Volleyball Team head coach. He and his team talked about their journey to achieving the gold medal in the 2016 Olympics and the struggles they had to overcome, such as losing to China multiple times in major tournaments, which was the number one team in the world at that time, and then beating them in the Olympic gold medal match in 2016.
We are down to our last supper. This is Saturday night, the last day of the clinic. We're leaving tomorrow morning. So this is our last meal in the cafeteria. We got this pizza burger. This is a special burger today. It's got pepperoni, beef patty, mozzarella cheese, and arugula, and I put some tomatoes on that. I made myself a turkey and ham sandwich with lettuce and tomatoes. Got, looks like steamed peas and carrots with probably tilapia and basmati rice. And I actually met a cool fan, Dimitri from Ukraine. He plays professionally in Europe for I think over 10 years, and now he's coaching, and he said he watches my videos, so shout out to Dimitri. Thanks for watching my videos and supporting my YouTube channel. But today's the last day. We tried to sneak into the gym to play some volleyball, but we couldn't find any volleyballs, and we probably would have gotten in trouble anyway, so we don't want to get blacklisted by USA Volleyball. So we're probably gonna just chill out tonight, and then we gotta fly out tomorrow. So this dessert was inspired by Lam. He made his own McFlurry with the soft serve ice cream and bits of Oreo. So now we're officially calling it a McFloppy because it's not the real McFlurry, but it's good enough. It's the ghetto version. I usually don't eat dessert, but I'm trying to live it up because we're at the HP clinic. I feel like I'm at science camp, like a little kid, having so much fun. And it was the first time I drank real Coke in a long time. I usually don't drink it because it's such high sugar content, but like I said, I'm living large. Instead of doing drugs, I'd rather eat my McFloppy and drink Coke. Not do Coke, drink Coke.
Here's another inspirational image of Reed Pretty and Ryan Millar blocking the opposite from Italy, whose name is Sottoretti. You know you watch too much volleyball when you can name almost any national team volleyball player you see.
It's 8 a.m. on Sunday morning. This is our last day. It's been like 60, 65 degrees in Colorado, which is pretty warm for this time. We're actually able to walk around with like t-shirts and shorts, and then we wake up today and it's got some powdered sugar everywhere and snow. But still not super cold. So finally got some Colorado weather. We're gonna eat our last breakfast. And then we're gonna fly home and then feel depressed because we don't want this to end. It's our last breakfast. Kyle. Made myself a toast, egg and bacon sandwich.
Oh, here we go.
And crunch potatoes, yogurt, granola, eggs with cheese and mushrooms. We got a special guest, Wayne, from Monta Vista. Cannot escape Wayne. Cool guy.
Keep an eye on you guys.
Been around in the volleyball community for a long time, so a lot of knowledge.
Yeah, over 2 years.
Only? Yeah, right. You're from Hawaii, you're born in volleyball.
No, never played volleyball in Hawaii. Can you believe that?
Here we are waiting at the Denver airport, and we're walking to our gate. And then all of a sudden, we all smell this strong cinnamon smell. And we're like, dude, we gotta eat whatever that is. And we smell cinnamon rolls, so we found a little Sara Lee sandwich shop. See that sign? And then Tian ordered the, of course, the most unique one, the pecan cinnamon roll and ice water. And I got the regular cinnamon roll with milk, and Lam got a smoothie with regular cinnamon roll. So yeah, sometimes you just gotta follow your nose. You don't follow your heart all the time, just follow your nose. Wow, that was an awesome experience. I just came back from the SFO airport, so I just flew back Sunday afternoon. Now I'm home, and my mind is still churning and processing all the awesome information that all the coaches provided, the conversations I had with the players and the other coaches there, and there's a lot of stuff to think about, but overall it was such an awesome experience to hang out with other volleyball junkies who are obsessed and passionate about growing the game, becoming better coaches, and sharing their love for the game as well. And I also had a great time hanging out with Coach Lam and Coach T, the two coaches from my high school. So we got a chance to talk about some of the things that we want to apply to our program and our team. So we're looking forward to those changes. I hope you guys enjoyed my vlog so you have a better idea of what a USA HP coaching clinic is like, so you know what it's like to attend a USA Volleyball HP coaching clinic. I'll be making another video as a formal review of my experience of the USA HP coaching clinic, so make sure you stay tuned for that one. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys next time. We'll